rap music we see today is nothing but hypnosis over young black youth. Young black males see these people on TV and they admire them like they're superheroes. The federal government has known since the Woodstock days that if you control the music, you control the children. The richest people in the federal government are afraid of the black man. No one knows why. No one knows what for. Maybe there's a deep-seated fear that if the black man were to become educated that they would get the whites back for slavery. That's just paranoia to me. You know how we celebrate Martin Luther King Day, but did you know the federal government called him America's most dangerous man? Dangerous? He was a preacher. How was he dangerous? They had to make sure that another Martin Luther King would never emerge. So for 10 years after his death, the only black man you saw on TV was a pimp, a drug dealer, or a gangster. The same thing is still going on today. Billionaires find poor black men and offer them millions of dollars to act like clowns and monkeys on national TV. These rappers are working for the government and don't even know it. Black people have no culture since we're basically a made-up race. So black people are always searching for an identity. The federal government said, hey, let's convince all black men that they're supposed to be thugs, crooks, irresponsible, uneducated, and flashy. This is the reason why nearly all rappers on TV are black. The rappers just see the money that they're being paid and don't realize that they're nothing but high-priced puppets and a bigger plan to destroy the black race. It's working, though. Think about it. Think about this. Whenever a white boy has his pants below his ass, what do we say? We say he's acting black. You see how hypnotized we are? We actually think that dressing like a dumbass thug makes you black. This plan is working perfectly. Whenever you see a black man riding around on big rims and he has gold teeth and wears his pants below his ass, he's not doing that because he wants to. He looks at his skin and thinks that's what he's supposed to be doing. The government knows that black people are searching for their role in America, and rap music tells young black men that's who they're supposed to be. I know people are going to say I'm crazy or I'm thinking too deeply, but this is for real. These rappers get paid all that money to be puppets and monkeys. Most of these buyers of the CDs are white, but they look at this strictly as entertainment. Black kids in the inner city look at this as a way of life. I know somebody's going to say, well, hip-hop just reflects reality. That's not true. Hip-hop creates reality. When NWA released Fuck the Police, violence against cops rose 300%. That alone shows you how powerful rap is. I think that this was the turning point in rap. When Fuck the Police was released, the government said, we can use this to control the black youth. They think it's funny. They get together and say, let's get all black men to put gold teeth in their mouth. And they pay rappers to do it. Now everyone else is doing it. I bet you they had a meeting and said, hey, let's see if we can get all black men to wear pink like girls. Next thing you know, Cameron's got all that pink shit on. And everybody in the inner city and all over the country was wearing pink back in like 03, 04. You remember that crap? Black men need to wake up and realize that rap videos are on TV for a reason. Are you watching these guys in the video? Look at these idiots. I used to like Cash Money until I realized that this was just hypnosis. It's just trying to hypnotize me. There's a reason why rappers get paid so much. It's because the government wants to reward black men for being who they're supposed to be. You know, kind of like how Denzel and Halle got their Oscars. You know, Denzel had to be a crook and Halle had to be a slut. They're trying to tell you that's who your black ass is supposed to be.